Today, Batten Down the Hatches, a new Google update is rolling out. Snapchat has some new toys for media buyers. Facebook totally isn't doing anything shady with its new security feature, guys. YouTube community building may get easier, and a big Instagram frustration has been fixed. It's Wednesday, November 17th, 2021. Happy National Unfriend Day, United States. I'm Todd Maffin from EngageQ Digital, and here's what you missed today in Digital Marketing, episode 506. Today's episode is brought to you by CMOX. See if you have what it takes to be a high-paid, in-demand, fractional chief marketing officer. Go to becomecmo.com. And parents, there is one bad word in the YouTube story at the end of today's episode. All right, let's get started. Supply chain problems, shipping delays. What else could possibly go wrong for businesses this holiday season? How about a change to Google's algorithm? Just 2 weeks before Black Friday, Cyber Monday, and the biggest online shopping season. Yes, Google has announced it's rolling out a new core update starting today. Core updates are usually pretty big. They only do them two or three times a year. No word on specifically what they're changing here. Google says it typically takes about 1 to 2 weeks to fully roll out. So how do you know if the update lowers your ranking? There's a pretty solid Search Central blog post, although it is from 2019, but still valid today, where Google outlines how you can track this and also recommends you give your website a self-assessment with a list of quality and content questions. Link to that post in the premium newsletter. Some platforms like Moz and SEMrush can also help. May the update be in your favor. Snap, the company behind the Snapchat app, is introducing a streamlined multiple formats delivery option for placing ads. This will allow marketers to purchase all of Snap's video formats in one ad set. Multi-format delivery covers collection ads, commercials, Snap ads, and story ads. And Snap's augmented reality camera offerings will be added by the Q2 of 2022. Snapchat advertisers will soon see a multiple formats ad set option within Snap Ads Manager and then can bundle different creative options for placement. Multi-format is being launched this week. A couple of weeks ago, Meta, you know, Facebook, announced it would be deleting the 1 billion facial recognition templates it has of its users because something, we're a good company now. And for a brief moment, maybe people believed they'd turned a corner and decided to do the right thing. It was, though, a brief moment. Instagram is now asking some users to give them, wait for it, images of their faces. This time it's not that pesky lo-fi image template. No, now they want a full video that shows your face from multiple angles. To be fair, this is all part of an apparent security update to verify users' identities, according to screenshots posted to Twitter by Matt Navarra. Instagram then followed up with a tweet saying it's asking suspicious accounts to prove there's a person behind an account and not a bot. One user's screenshots shows Instagram's instructions to slowly turn your head to get all angles of your face. Instagram says that the video selfie feature will not actually use facial recognition, technically speaking, and that the video will be deleted after 30 days. While the promise not to store any data may reassure some users, it may be hard to sell those who are already wary of Meta's privacy policies. Heads up, social media people, YouTube is testing new features to give you more channel management options. By the way, parents, this is not the YouTube story I was talking about earlier. This one's safe. The new features are within YouTube Studio and Brand Connect and are designed to provide more functionality for managing channel engagement, as well as more options to help content creators secure branded content deals and monetize their work. Here's a look into the new features, some of which are just being tried out, by the way. First, the Channel Guidelines filtering tool is being expanded to more creators. This feature allows creators to define up to 3 channel guidelines for video comments. Users have to read and accept these guidelines before they make a comment, and they're a good guide as to what conversations you want to see on your own channel. This feature will not cause comments to be hidden or removed. YouTube notes it is an experiment that is only available to iOS and Android users and may only be available for a short period of time. Second, improving tools for partnerships with brands and creators. An updated paid product placement checkbox and new Media Kit audience tools. Creators in this experiment will see the existing video contains paid promotion checkbox become required in the upload flow to indicate if their content includes a brand deal. They're also testing a new audience summary within the YouTube brand Connect interface that makes it easier for creators to pitch themselves for brand deals using a tailored media kit. And a new feature within the Takedown web form that will allow you to automatically prevent copies of content that you have removed from being uploaded. YouTube has also expanded access to its copyright match tool for creators. His name is Joed Karim. He's standing outside an elephant exhibit in a zoo.
All right, so here we are, one of the elephants. Cool thing about these guys is that they have really, really, really long trunks.
It's a short video, not even 20 seconds. And how do I say this gently? It's not very interesting. It's blurry. Karim himself seems a little bored by it all, too.
And that's pretty much all there is to say.
But this video has more than 200 million views on YouTube. Why? Because it's the first video ever uploaded to the platform. Karim was a co-founder of the fledgling site back when he posted it 16 years ago. And this week, that video got turned into something of a protest. Karim, apparently mad at the decision to remove public dislike counts from YouTube videos, changed the video's description to a bit of a rant on the topic. Quoting him, "When every YouTuber agrees that removing dislikes is a stupid idea, it probably is. Try again, YouTube. Why would YouTube make this universally disliked change? There is a reason, but it's not a good one, and not one that will be publicly disclosed. Instead, there will be references to various studies, studies that apparently contradict the common sense of every YouTuber. The ability to easily and quickly identify bad content is an essential feature of a user-generated content platform. Why? Because not all user-generated content is good. It can't be. In fact, most of it is not good. And that's okay. The idea was never that all content is good. The idea was, however, that among the flood of content, there are great creations waiting to be exposed. And for that to happen, the stuff that's not great has to fall by the side as quickly as possible. The process works, and there's a name for it. The wisdom of crowds. The process breaks when the platform interferes with it. Then the platform invariably declines. Does YouTube want to become a place where everything is mediocre? Because nothing can be great if nothing is bad. In business, there's only one more thing important than make it better, and that's don't fuck it up. And finally, something many social media managers have been waiting for, Instagram now lets you delete one photo out of a carousel. If you don't like an image or video in a carousel, now, finally, you can click edit, scroll to the image, and click delete in the top left corner. As Borat would say,
wow, wow, is very nice.
Estamos rompiendo.
So I don't know if you follow Canadian news at all, but, despite everything going on, including the supply chain issues, we here on the west coast of Canada have an even bigger problem when it comes to supply chain, and that is that the city of Vancouver and surrounding municipalities are basically cut off now from the rest of the country. And that is because of massive, massive flooding that took out some major highways and railways, by the way, because they ran alongside the highway. So, yeah, supply chain issues times three. So, you know, be grateful you've at least got roads where you are. Talk to you tomorrow.
Attention agency owners and marketing consultants. The new iOS updates aren't the only thing changing in today's marketing landscape. The role of the marketer is getting disrupted by high-quality talent across the globe, forcing your prices to decrease. If you've seen your marketing rates stagnate or decrease in the last 2 years, you need to do something new. Here's the truth. When you work, you can focus on solving small problems. As a result, you deserve small rewards. But if you could instead focus on solving bigger problems in those same hours, your income increases with your impact. Hey, I'm Casey Stanton, and I train marketing consultants and agency owners to become fractional chief marketing officers so they can ascend to the top role in a company, find new work for their agencies, and push their clients to record revenue and growth. Our fractional CMOs are paid to do the fun stuff, marketing strategy. If you want a full pipeline of great prospects with a simple and clear way to sell and service them as a fractional chief marketing officer, go to becomecmo.com. If you have more than 3 years of marketing experience, see if you have what it takes to be a successful fractional CMO at becomecmo.com.
Is that Dunkin's new holiday blend coffee?
Sure is, because sometimes the holidays just call for Dunkin'.
What's in it? A spark of holiday spirit?
A cup full of holiday cheer?
Your very own holiday shopper?
Actually, all that. And notes of molasses and dried fruit. Just the warming blend I need for that holiday hustle.
Ah! Sit through the holidays with a $2 medium holiday blend coffee at Dunkin'. America runs on Dunkin'. Participation may vary. Limited time offer. Exclusions apply.
It's not just Santa who's coming to town for the holidays. It's your relatives, and boy, are they hungry. So stop by the Home Depot for up to 25% off appliances. Plus, save up to $750 instantly. No rebates, no hassles. Not only will you get a great deal on a fridge, you'll save enough to fill it up with food. Make the holidays yours at the Home Depot. How doers get more done. Valid November 3rd through December 1st. U.S. only. Gas appliances. Extra offer valid on select appliances and while supplies last. See online or associate in-store for details.